Hello and welcome to another episode of On the Bench with Pete. And as it's November now, well, I'll talk about that later, but essentially this is going to be about tidying up what I've got rather than starting anything new. So as you all know, it was recently October, so I've got a lot of orcs left, but I've packed some away, so it's not all of them. So the ones that are finished I've packed away. I'm just going to be finishing up some of these orcs and stuff. I've still got Ravenwing Bikers and a couple of Blood Angels and Dark Angels. It goes on a bit. But I'm not starting anything new this month. So grab yourselves a brush and a model, or two, or ten, whatever. Cup of tea, coffee, whatever your poison is. And let's start getting rid of all these unpainted models. Okay, let's get into it. Okay, so as you can see here, if I zoom out, that's not all of them, that's just some of them. Alright, so I'm going to be trying to finish up on these guys. So just paint along as I try and get these guys finished. So obviously I'm looking at each one, thinking, right, what's to do with him. Some of them are nearly there. Right, so still a little bit of gunmetal to do. Alright, so that's what we're going to be doing. A little bit of that. It's going to be so random. Just popping a little bit onto my palette. Get the right brush, of course. If I ever can. Right. Dampness of the brush, and this is how I'm going to do it. So remember, this is low quality, not showcasing models or how to paint or anything like that. This is just your chance to paint along with me, get some stuff done, and yeah, I mean, October was incredibly productive for me, I gotta say. It was brilliant. You know, I got so much stuff done. And I've come away, although I haven't, you know, finished the box set, which, you know, obviously I would have liked to have done. But I didn't expect to for one moment. I'm so much further on with it. And this is all stuff I don't have to do anymore. Right, so as far as I'm concerned, actually, his trousers need doing, so I was going to say, as far as I was concerned, he's done, but he's not. So, anyone else needing gun metal? So, this is what I'm going to do. Just going to go for them all. No, I guess he's all gun metaled out. Anyone else? Anyone else for gun metal? Anyone else for gun metal? You've done most of it here. Now, I'll do the bottom of his boots. But yeah, so October, or October even, it's been and gone. Obviously, I'll do orcs like I'm doing now, obviously, in the meantime. But yeah, it was fun. Keep doing the orky updates. It meant I was concentrating on orcs more, so getting more orcs done than anything else, like scenery or anything else. And it was all good fun, you know. There we go. That's him. Anyone for gunmetal? I'm not going to spend too long on it, you know. are some things. Okay. So, another thing at the end of October brought was my daughter's birthday. So that went ahead without a hitch, which was cool, all nice and smooth. 16 already. I can't believe it. How fast they grow up. 16 years old. I can't even remember being 16 so long ago. But yeah, we went out, we had a good time with family and that. It was all good. I'll just do a couple of bits of gold metal on the corn red of these guns here. Got a bit of a buckle thing going on there. Yeah, so that's all good there. Yeah, daughter's birthday. So she's into Harry Potter at the moment, so yeah, got her some Harry Potter stuff, which went down well. And we went for a nice meal out at a Greek restaurant. It was all very good. Very good indeed. I'm just making sure I've not missed any other points on this one. No, I don't think so. I do not think so. Some of the final layers on the knobs later. Yeah, and Halloween, of course, was the last day of the month. And I tried to do my video response. I recorded it on the Halloween evening. Yes, I did. Which probably wasn't my greatest idea. What with all the interruptions and so on. I'm just going to bring the camera over a bit. I'm going to keep leaning so far. Yeah, so that was good. Didn't get too many knocks on the door this year, but you know, we got a few. Like you do. So yeah, dogs bark obviously. When anyone knocks on the door. Oh, he's alright. And yeah. So what happens? Oh, get that screaming bell out again. Screaming bell is a pretty classic colour for these orcs, I'm thinking. Probably look good on the fantasy models too, screaming bell. In a lot of ways. It's not gold, it's more like a bronze effect. Yeah, it looks good. Didn't I just pick this guy up? Yeah, I did. Right. This dude, little grots. I love these grots, they're great. Handle on his little grenade thing he's got here. Oh yeah, we definitely need screaming bell chaps. Definitely. Yeah. So many little areas. So what's new? You may have seen the studio updates. The insulation is all in place. Just waiting for plasterer now. He's on holiday at the moment, the one we're using. So wait for him to come back. And he can plaster that up. we'll be good. And then we'll be sealing it and painting the interior. Then looking at the floor. Get the floor done. Then move in, baby. That's the plan. So, yeah. That's the plan. Alright, I'll just... I always do that. I tend to be more... closer to me. One day I'll get a decent camera angle and everyone will go, wow, that was good. Well done. Yeah, I'll put the gun metal here. So, I hope it's all going well for you chaps. Hope you're all having fun painting away there. Various painting challenges and so forth. I'll have to enter a couple next year, you know. See how I fare. Yeah, we're just touching up on this bit here. I see Mr. Riddick Beer, he's got himself a new set of equipment there, a camera and lighting, and that's all looking really, really good. It's going to really push his videos to the next level, I think. And they're already good, so yeah, looking forward to that. That's going to be awesome. It's like anything, when you get new equipment like that, you got to get used to it. Takes a while. Because everything's different. I mean, I got my new camcorder. So different to the old one. I mean, it's so much easier and better, but you kind of get used to one way. I think that's him, though. Or should I put metal there? Yes, I'm going to. I'm just talking to myself whilst I'm doing this as well. Sometimes I think out loud, so just ignore those bits of dialogue. Right. Also thinking about new series. What new series can I do? And, you know, I look at what's going down on other channels. I think, yeah, that might work. Do something similar, and that's what it's all about, finding what works. Right. Okay. Gun metal. So I must make sure I do Screaming Bell after this, because that will finish these up a bit more. Yeah, I think so. I'll need some rune fang steel on some of these guns, but yeah, it's not bad. Not bad at all. Screaming Bell is definitely going to be coming out there. Screaming Bell. So I'm thinking, for a new series, it's just an idea, like a kind of top 10 or top 5 or something along those lines, or a how to play series, not for Warhammer but for other games, like Ronin or something like that, or I don't know, just something. It would be cool. I do indeed. So yes, as I said at the beginning of the video, yes, November. My videos regarding painting for November are going to be like Neatvember, I think. Call it Neatvember. trying to tidy up and finish up, because my model collection's a mess. Gotta get it sorted. I want to start having games with Orks soon as well. You know, how cool would that be? Be like mega cool. Oh yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Another knob. Do you have any? Not really. That's the annoying part. Some of the things, it's not very much to do, can often take just as long as the large stuff, I find. Yes, I do. There we are. Bearing in mind, they're not going to be too up close, these guys. I like these other Orks as well, they're kind of like old school. These ones here, they're kind of like old school, looks like they're quite funny. Yeah. Good. Couple of little bits and we're in good shape. And there's a fly in here, which is very annoying, very irritating. Irritating like my nose is. Some of the axes have broken off on these, but that's okay. Basically my cannon fodder guys anyway. Someone's slamming doors next door, I believe. There we are, just a couple of bits of gun and metal on there. Yeah, see these guys, they won't last long. Right, could turn that into a silver shackle kind of wristband, metal bracelet, I don't know what you call it. Wrist brace, that's what they'll call it. But yeah, Orks. Love the Orks. I know they're not the most powerful army out there, but they're one of the most fun ones, I think. As opposed to, say, something like, I don't know, Old Tau. I'll say Old Tau because I know they've got a new codex out and I have absolutely no idea what's in it or what it's done to their meta. So I regard Old Tau as kind of a boring army in terms of all they do is sit back and shoot. I know that's the point of them. I get that. And I appreciate it. You know, not a problem. I don't have a problem with that. That's their thing, you know. But it's not one I want to play against very often. Maybe it's more fun to play. Maybe it's a bit like cricket. Tau are like cricket in that they're more fun to play than to watch. Well, I'll do anything that's more fun to play than to just watch, but you know, you appreciate them more when you play them as opposed to when you're just watching them. Yeah, that's what I meant. Put some. Is There's all a lot of bits and bobs on the back, so I'm not even sure what they are. Is it a grenade? I don't know. Could be. It could be. But I don't know. Don't know. So, let's go back to the other two. I'm just going to do his whole shoulder pad silver. Just easier. Yeah. So I want to spend this month, any painting I do this month, I want to spend just finishing up stuff. That's kind of my goal for November. So yeah. So going back to my response video, topic of the week. I just want to say how much I enjoy Vince Venturella's topic of the week. It's just really cool. I don't, you know, I've only posted two responses now. But I do, I enjoy watching other people's responses on certain matters. Right. Yeah, lovely to paint my cannon fodder. Yes. Awesome stuff. Orksum. Yes, let's have a get the shoulder pads. Alright. Ah, dear. So yeah, topic of the week. And this week it was, what does the hobby mean to you? And that was really cool. I like that. Like the 3D printing one from the other week. It's a lot, it's very thought provoking, some of it. It's good to stop and think, yeah. Do a video on it, you know? I mean, like I said at the intro of my video, I'm probably totally wrong, but that's just my thoughts. This will be a good stage getting done with these orcs. So there. Couple more of these old school ones left. Yeah, the only problem with batch painting can be a little boring, but then that's why I make these videos. So I can paint, express my thoughts, ramble on, passes the time, you know? Passes the time. Before you know it, you've been painting for an hour, or whatever, and you think, oh wow. I've done that level of green or blue or metal or whatever it might be, you know. Yeah, that's cool. I like that. Okay. Last old school one. This one with the mohawk. I'm sure that's going to be like a squigwig. He is in my army. Squigwig. Definitely. So this year, time Christmas comes around, I'll be on 70 odd P&Qs, which I was just looking at it, thinking there's a lot of Q&As, you know. I should hit the 500 video mark before Christmas. And that'll be cool. I know 500 videos isn't a lot compared to you know, what some of you have got out there, but then, you know, those of you that have been going a while, got a lot more, obviously. But in for a couple of years, I don't think that's bad, you know. Nearly 500 videos. I'm pretty chuffed with it. Oh yeah, I like that. That's good. Gruck face ripper, do you need any more gunmetal? Do ya? Do you need to do your thing? Don't think he does. No, we'll leave that. Just gonna wash my brush out in a moment. Have a sip of tea. Oh man. Okay, on with the remainder. This is the guy I cobbled together out of spares, so. He's pretty okay, really. But seeing as I have it open here, I'll just do a couple of areas. I find it always better to breathe out as I'm doing intricate areas. Certainly don't hold your breath when you're doing it. That's a bad habit because that can cause you to shake more. I like to take a breath, breathe out slowly as I do them. I don't know, it just works for me. You got to do whatever works for you, right guys? I like looking at the models. And what are they going to do? What can I do? I've got to do some more teeth as well on these guys. Just realizing. Okay. These are the ones I did the screaming bell on. Do we need to do any more? Yes, I think. A bit there, perhaps. It's like a half saw, half chainsaw. Sword. I keep saying saw. Half chainsword. Because it's not a saw. See, they don't go cutting hedges. Imagine that orc knocking on your door. It's creepy. Do you have any hedges that need cutting? I have my chainsaw. Yeah, that's not going to work, is it? I don't think he's going to exactly be able to do topiary with these things, you know. So he'll probably be out of a job pretty soonish, I imagine. Nobody would want your back, mate. Okay. Fur left on his helmet. He's okay, your son. Yep. Banking on a lot of them being okay. Some things you just need to re-establish. I gotta finish basing these dudes as well. I'm a big fan of the texture paints to base from, you know, 3W. And on the bigger models, I like the Vallejo stuff. It's just my own personal preference. And Vallejo basing kits that you can get. So I've got two of Dark Earth and like Medium Earth there. Metal spikes. Bit of a pain. Right, there you go. Right. Yeah, that needs to be, Screwing bell too, isn't it really? Okay, I'm just thinking out loud here. Any more for you? No, I don't think so. No, it doesn't even have a buckle. His eyepiece. Actually, be a little more intricate with this one. This is a cyborg, and he's got a cybernetic eye. So I'm just doing the outer casing for that. That's good. All good stuff here. Right, I'm sure I checked you. Yeah. We're getting there. Aha, buckle. So yeah, top 10s or top 5s. I might think about doing those. Maybe. Hum, 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 hum. Alright. So we've got a bit of your shapty bone to be doing as well. You shapty bone. So I think next we'll do the screaming bells. Buckles. Pretty intricate. Amazing what you miss on, or you think it's done. Right, when you think it's relatively done, and you actually go into it, there's actually a lot you kind of miss sometimes. And the paint dries up on your brush because there's so little of it on there. Real pain. Right. I suspect, once I'm in the studio, I'm either going to be concentrating on either, I mean I say concentrating on, I mean doing more of than other stuff. Concentrating on War Machine and Hordes, Ronin, maybe. When I say concentrate on, I mean painting the armies for, or painting images for, and Zombicide. But then that's not to say I won't be doing other terrain and stuff. Right, that's the gunmetal done. Yeah, obviously I'll still be doing 40k, I'll be doing battle reports as well, which is what I'm looking forward to doing. So I've got the stuff. Talk. I need to walk the walk. Right, screaming bell.
Gorgeous colour.
Once again, there's no need to fill it down too much, really. Dampness of the brush will do. So I'll work my way backwards now. I know that they're done for Screaming Bell. I think he was. Yeah, he needs his shabby bone now. Alright, so we'll start with these again then. He needs his trousers doing, I said, didn't I? So. Trousers. I'm undecided. Get him over there. Well, these are. See, some of these need a bit of Runefang steel on. And some of them need Screaming Bell. I'm using Screaming Bell to pick out things like iconery or stuff like that, you know. I think it makes it really cool. Makes it really pop. Okay. Alright. Screaming Bell. Let's get our orky stuff done in Screaming Bell. I like it. It's a good colour. It's not gold. Fab alternative, though. There we are. Screaming Bell chap. This grot, what's his story? Do a bit of a Screaming Bell on the bottom of his sword on the hilt bolt there. I think he's ready for actually he can have a Agrax Earthshade wash on his hat. He can be burnished. Almost done. Look at the knobs. I'm not about to do the squig on him yet, but I'm not concerning myself too much with that right now. Bit of a icon on the side of the gun here. So yeah. Cool. Anything else? Oh yes. Gun housing. Housing plate. So you can be Screaming Bell. Kind of like a status thing, although I really don't believe that orcs would be bothered about gold. Teeth is their currency anyway, so I just don't think they'd be bothered about it. I don't think they'd care less, unless it just looks shiny and pretty. Use that as a status symbol, I suppose. We can do the backs of these bullets though, can't we? That might look cool. Yeah, that does look cool. Right. Alright, yeah, definitely looks cool. Okay, next knob. Do you have a icon? No, you don't. Well, I don't know what happened. It's fine. Whatever. Yep. Next one. They don't all have icons on their guns, I notice. I don't know why I put so many guns on them, because they're not a shooty army. Well, I just did. Just wanted to give them the opportunity. Do you know, he's near completion. I'm thinking. I'm going to put some on the, just below the shoulder pads, the metal guards under there, the buckle guards, I would imagine they are. He doesn't want his armour to come unstrapped. Definitely taking precautions. Alright. Yeah, I'm liking that. Near completion. Yeah, so I've got like a near completion pile. It's hard, isn't it, to say, yep, that one's done now. Very hard. Right. Screaming bell. This here, I think it's a spanner. Yeah, that's good. So my wife went to the Rocky Horror Show the other evening. Well, you might have seen the video just before she left with her friend. They did a WAG, which was quite funny, I thought. Yeah, I had a good time. Rocky Horror. Not exactly my scene. It's a bit of a weird one, that Rocky Horror, but... So, I'm liking how this is looking. A couple of cables to do and skin. Yeah, so he's not nearly complete, not like the other ones. Alright, so onwards and upwards. Screaming bell. Nah, he's okay. This fellow, screaming bell. You have a screen, but oh, maybe the bottom of his staff. Give it a bit of contrast to the rest of it. Handle. So it's not gold, but I really don't think Orks would care one way or the other about that. That flies back, really annoying. Really annoying. This is good, it's intricate work. It does take time, and I've got to do it at some point anyway, right? So I might as well do it whilst making a video, I figure. That's what I figure. Yeah. Sometimes you're looking at these thinking, right, what's next? Do for him. Any screaming bell here? Belt buckle or something there going on. So yeah, you can have a bit of a screaming bell for that. Oh yeah. That looks good. Yeah, I'd say he's nearly done. Good in the nearly done pile. Did I do him? No. Sometimes the subtlest of things can make a huge difference on these models. Yeah, it's like filling in nuts and bolts. Things like that. Okay. Oh yeah, he's got a icon on his gun. You know, like the Orky icon. That's good, all cool. Excellent. Icon. I think there's a lot to be said for breathing in this hobby. When you're painting certain intricate things, breathing in the right way, I think it really helps. So I think it's good for you. Oh, I'm just going to put in a couple of gloves on here. So yeah, I'll be doing more on war. So I've got a war machine starter army of Signar. That was what I decided to go with. Signar for war machine. Will be my beginning faction. So I'm going to learn the game with Signar. And so I haven't even assembled them, let alone painted them yet. So I've got a couple for that. I've got a couple of mercenaries to go with it as well, so they can go with any other war machine faction I get, you know, so that will be good. I think once I'm through with Screaming Bell, I think the video will be up. You think we'll be at about an hour then? I'm thinking. Just in the middle of this. Hoping you're getting stuff done. This is splendid for me here, doing this. Absolutely love it. And I find this. This is what I'm talking about. This is relaxing. This is what I'm talking about. You know? Totally relaxing. I can hear my dog do something. What are you doing, Millie? I hear she's up to something. What icon? I don't need to water these down because it actually helps raise the profile of the actual, because it's a molded bit of detail, so it brings detail up, it raises the level up, which is cool. Bit of a shake there. I'm not hungry though. That's fine. Don't think we've got too much in the way of Screaming Bell over this side. Do a bit around his yellow shoulder pad to see what that looks like. Might look okay. Yeah, looks all right. Yeah, getting a little shaky, but that's okay. We can still handle this. Nearly done anyway. What do I think it looks like? It's okay. Don't know. It's, you know. Jury's out on that one. I have to think about it. Stick to these icons. Which is good. Yeah. And as for these, I think we agreed. That screaming bell was kind of... not required too much. I think we're done on these. Yeah, we did them all, didn't we? Alright. Okay, well we're coming up on the hour, we're not there yet, so I'm just checking to see if I missed any on Screaming Bell. Well, there won't be no more. That's it for Screaming Bell, but I do have some new shabty bone to do. Oh, so they're looking pretty sweet. I've got basing to do as well on some of these. I can't think why I haven't based him. Or put any basing on him at all. Now I've got to find, there it is, Black Fire Earth. So I can do that. So, I think I was dreaming going off, talking about going on to the Raven Wing. That's, just not going to happen, is it? Right, okay, find a brush. Old naked brush. I like to base these in Black Fire F, that looks cool. Nice helping on there. Once this is dry, I shall be applying a wash and a dry brush to highlight it up. Yeah, as I was saying earlier, these texture paints from the Citadel, brilliant. I mean, yeah, I could use sand and paint the sand, but it's already done for me here, there we go. So he's got his first thing of base on. Ta-da! Right, that's that. Well, I'm bad. Finish up my tea. So let's zoom out slightly. So that is gunmetal and Screaming Bell, which is it's a rather nice colour. It's like a coppery colour, I suppose, not a bronzy colour, whatever. So it's when you don't, it's ideal for when you don't want to do gold, but you want to do something metallic but not silver, I find. So yes. So let's zoom right out, swing the camera back to me, and thank you so much for joining me on this episode of On the Bench with Pete. It's been a blast, as always. Yeah, it may not seem like much, but that's a ton of painting work done there, and a good 50 minutes worth of work there. So hope you got stuff done too. Glad you could join me. Remember, all brushes lead to war. See you on the next one, guys.